Lottie, 2 weeks since you got back from Sri Lanka, how do you reflect on the World T20?
Yeah, obviously, you know, it's still bitterly disappointing because you go there with a goal and you've not achieved that goal. But, you know, I'm very proud of what the players achieved. I think we shouldn't panic too much. I think it's just about us now having an immediate focus now of the 50 over World Cup. You know, the Australians played really well, and I think a lot of credit has to go to them. And, you know, it just wasn't to be our day. But yeah, I'm very proud, and looking now forward to the 50 over competition.
Almost flawless getting through to the final. Did you think you were going to be getting your hands on the trophy again?
Yeah, I think so. I think our form had been fantastic, and we seem to be sort of getting better with each game. And you know, we know where we went wrong. We're a really honest group, and I think like you said, we've reflected on it after the final, and you know, we know exactly where we lost it, and that's not any blame on anyone. It's just like I say, Australia were better than us on the given day.
So close in that final. What was the overriding emotion in the change room afterwards?
Well, it's just, you know, so close. I think sometimes you'd rather lose by 30 than lose by 4, because then you start sort of nitpicking at certain, you know, situations. But obviously everyone's, you know, when you've worked so hard for something, and I think probably for us as well, you know, we'd won so many games in the last 2 years as well, and for that one game to be that World Cup final, I think we'd have given away a lot of the other wins to have taken a victory there. But it was a great occasion. It was a great advert for women's cricket, and I think that's what we've all got to be very proud of, as not just England players, but you know, for women's cricket as a whole. And I think I've definitely come away really positive and looking forward to what's ahead now.
You mentioned about the advert for women's cricket, and the profile of the game got a massive boost, didn't it?
Yeah, I think we were unaware really of how much media was back home and how many people were supporting us. I've had so many people come up to me since we're back. It's all been really positive feedback, which is always great when you know you've narrowly missed out. So like I say, really positive. It's not something, you know, I think as a team we're going to dwell on too much. I think it's really important that we've done as well as we possibly can, and I think most of the girls would come back and we've got absolutely no regrets. And just looking forward to more challenges ahead of the team.
What about from a personal point of view, player of the tournament? Must be really pleased with that.
Yeah, it's you know, I've worked, you know, I think everyone sort of realised from the summer I wasn't in the greatest form. I went away, I worked hard. So for me personally, it's great that, you know, all that hard work pays off. But I think it's little consolation. You know, I think I would much rather have probably got 5 ducks and thus won the World Cup than me win player of the tournament. But I think as I've said before, I think in a couple of years' time, I think it's something you'll look back on and be, you know, really proud of being a player of the tournament.
And that's going to be a switch from 20 over cricket to 50 over cricket, and obviously the World Cup next year. What's the plans between now and then?
Yeah, it's really nice that we've got, like I say, an immediate focus ahead of us, and you know, we've got a big 2 months of training, and really looking forward to it. I think, you know, it's subcontinent again, which is good, so we know what we're going to be up against. I think that will hopefully stand us in good stead. So, you know, we've got a great 50-over record. You know, we're current champions as well. So hopefully that will give us lots of confidence going into that competition. And you know, we've just got to prepare well, like we have done in all our other tournaments. And hopefully this time that will be on our side.
Is 2 months enough, you know, to sort of get back into 50-over cricket?
Yeah, well, we'll soon see. I think it's nice the girls have had a bit of a break. I think it's been a long summer for us all. So a lot of our energies have been pushed into 2020 cricket, but I think it's quite nice to have a different focus now. And like I say, it's an opportunity for people to bowl longer spells and bat big. So you know, that's something we'll be obviously trying to get across to the team over the winter training sessions we've got, and then off to India on January 16th for a training camp, and then straight into the World Cup. So it's going to be a busy few months ahead.
Obviously, as defending champions, you won't want to give up that trophy easily, will you?
No, we won't. And I think maybe this might just, you know, having had the disappointment we've just had, I think hopefully it'll add an extra edge to our training over the next few months, and obviously give us obviously a greater edge going into that competition. But no, we won't be giving up lightly. We fought to the end in the 2020, and we'll do exactly the same. You know, this team's full of fighters, and hopefully that will continue in India in February.